Arizona's magnificent and absolutely stunning Grand Canyon is often thought of as the world's deepest canyon, providing spectacular displays of rock that span 1.84 billion years in age. Yet, not only is the Grand Canyon not the deepest canyon on land in the world, but it is not even the deepest canyon in the United States. For reference, the deepest point of the Grand Canyon measures 6,093 feet or 1,857 meters deep. Meanwhile, Idaho's Hell's Canyon is up to 8,066 feet deep, while California's Kings Canyon is up to 8,264 feet or 2,519 meters deep. Yet, these scenic features are not even close in scope to the world's deepest canyon, as on another section of the planet, a partially forested river canyon is bordered on both sides by glacier-covered peaks which tower beyond 20,000 feet in height. There, steep river canyons mark the deepest point of what is known as the Yarlung Zangbo Grand Canyon, which is up to 19,714 feet or 6,009 meters deep. This is the story of this little-known and remote canyon which is located in the interior of Asia. The Yarlung Zangbo Grand Canyon can be found at the edge of southern China, where it is 230 kilometers north-northwest of the Indian city of Namsai. This deep canyon begins at a settlement known as Daduka Village and traverses 504.9 kilometers or 313.7 miles of mountainous terrain until it reaches its endpoint at the village of Baxica. While it might initially seem like the lengthy year-long Zangbo Grand Canyon was carved by glaciers during Rupia glacial periods in the last 2.6 million years, according to more recent research, this was only a minor factor. Note how the tight canyons which the Yarlung Zangbo River runs through do not have the distinctive U-shape that glacially carved valleys have, but is rather defined by the classic V-shape indicating significant river-based erosion. So, how did what was likely more than 10,000 feet in some areas get carved by water only in the last 3 to 4 million years? The answer relates to how the Himalayan mountain range formed in the first place. Part of this story involves the Indian tectonic plate, which itself comprises almost all of India and parts of surrounding countries. While this tectonic plate is today actively colliding with the Eurasian plate to the north, this was not always the case. Around 100 million years ago, the Indian subcontinent, which at the time was located in the middle of the southern hemisphere, started to separate from Antarctica and the island of Madagascar, heading north into the open ocean as an island. By 60 million years ago, the northern part of this tectonic plate reached the equator and continued northwards. Finally, 50 million years ago, the Indian subcontinent began colliding with the Eurasian tectonic plate in what is known as a convergent collision. Not only did this force the Eurasian plate and significant volumes of adjacent limestone upwards, but it also caused the subducting Indian plate slab to snap off. The Himalayas continued to be constructed over the following tens of millions of years, with Mount Everest rising by 8 kilometers elevation during the last 30 million years. However, the region which marks where the Yarlung Zangbo Grand Canyon would form was initially only a gentle sloping river valley. While this river valley already existed along a low point between two compressed blocks of material, something suddenly changed around 2.5 million years ago. All of a sudden, a localized section of the Himalayas began uplifting at a far higher rate than its surroundings, at a rate of approximately 3 meters a century. This caused a steep section to form which contained a depression in its center, resulting in the creation of a large lake. Eventually, this lake overtopped this boundary and began carrying large fragments of rock and sediment at high speeds as material flowed down a now greatly sloped region which accelerated the water. This speed somewhat quickly caused fragments of rock the river carried to gouge away at underlying rock, and over the following 2.5 million years, this process carved away as much as 10,000 or even 15,000 feet of rock in some locations. As a final note, I would like to thank my new patron Ty W for supporting this channel.